Hello students, in this video we are going to study about the fixed capital. This is a type of a capital which you have already studied in class 11th. Fixed capital is a type of a capital which is invested in fixed assets for a longer duration. And I hope you remember that at the time of teaching you financing decisions, investing decisions had two types of investment policy, long term and short term. At that time, I have already explained you one of the terms, but here we are going to quickly revise that fixed capital is allocation of firm's capital to large term assets or projects. So when the company's assets, the company's capital is getting invested in the fixed assets, in the long-term projects for a longer duration, we considered that amount as a fixed capital. And I hope you remember that I have told you that if the capital is invested for a longer duration, it is also named as capital budgeting decisions, right? So I have already taught you the factors which affect the capital budgeting decision in the previous video. In this video, we are going to cover the two topics. One is importance of capital budgeting decisions, right? And the factors affecting the requirement of the fixed capital. Fine, starting up with the importance. Here the first importance is long-term growth. Now when we talk about the long-term growth, it says that the company is having a long-term effect by taking this decision. When the finance manager takes this decision, the long-term effect is there because the money is invested in the asset for a longer duration. The things cannot be changed. So the investment is for long, and for that long-term investment, a proper planning needs to be done because a quick and sudden changes or frequent changes is not possible. And then if the planning has been done properly, definitely this decision brings a long-term growth in the organization. Point number two is large amount of funds involved. Now since the company is investing its assets in a long-term project, in the long-term assets, in the fixed assets, the money is getting blocked, the money is getting involved, the fund is getting involved for a longer duration. So here again, it has to be kept in mind that what is the revenue which is getting generated, right? The revenue must also get calculated at the time of investing these funds, because they may prove to be riskier if it is not calculated properly. The next importance, why this decision is important, because it helps in calculating the risk factor. As I said over here, revenue matters since the amount is getting blocked in the organization, in the assets for a longer duration. So risk factor affects the organization, its planning, and even the revenue for the long needs to get calculated, that if the amount will be blocked for long, how long is the revenue going to be generated with the blockage of that funds in the fixed assets or in the long-term projects. Next is irreversible decision. Irreversible decisions means any decision which cannot be changed. And if the organization has taken any decision, started implementing it, and then trying to reverse it, right? Now trying to change it, definitely it will incur a huge loss, huge wastages. So the importance is that these decision helps on certain grounds to the finance manager before executing anything in the practical. Now we are going to study what are the factors that affect the requirement of the fixed capital. When the organization or when the finance manager is in need of funds, definitely either it will be needing capital, fixed capital, or it will be needing the working capital. Fixed capital is used for in the fixed assets, as I told you, for the long-term assets, for the long-term projects, whereas the other one, working capital, which we'll be studying in the next video, working capital is used for the day-to-day activities, for the daily purpose, routine work. The amount which is getting used, that is called as working capital. So when we talk about the first factor, that is nature of business. Now, when we talk about sectors, I know you know that there are three sectors: agriculture, production, primary, secondary, and tertiary. That is agriculture, production, and services. Now, we are not including the primary sector over here, the agriculture sector over here. We are talking about the other two sectors, that is production and services, secondary and tertiary. Now, if it is a trading, right? Trading is a type of a sector which involves only if, and on that we are only majorly focusing on the secondary sector right now. And we're talking about trading companies and manufacturing companies. Now, what are trading companies? Trading companies means buying from some vendor and selling it to some other party is just the trading, right? Taking its profit margin. So, in that case, the company requires very small fixed assets, fixed capital. But if it is a manufacturing company, that means it is buying the raw material from many vendors, assembling the product, testing it, checking it, and then finally selling it after packing it, selling it into the market after packing and packaging it. Then definitely for all these activities, it requires large amount of fixed capital. Next one is scale of operation. Now, if the organization is big, if the organization is large, definitely it will require more fixed capital. And if the organization is working on a smaller level, definitely it will require less fixed capital. Point number three is explaining the production technique. Now, there are two types of production technique: labor and capital. Labor means where more of human resources involved in doing the production work, and capital means where heavy machineries are performing the production job. So if it is a capital technique, it will require higher fixed capital, and if it is a labor, it will require low. Reason behind: the heavy machineries require a lot and lot of maintenance as compared to the labor intensive technique. Next, we have technology upgradation. Now, if the company is having a technology, definitely it will require more fixed capital because the technology needs to get updated with the span of time. Because the technology gets old with the usage and with the time. So, definitely over here, higher fixed capital is required. Growth prospect, if any organization is looking towards the opportunity of growth, is planning to expand in the future, is planning to do something new in the future, definitely if there is a growth prospect, here it is, if it's planning to grow, definitely high fixed capital is required. And if there is no such planning, the company is going to perform the way it has been performing, then they don't need that much of fixed capital. The requirement is going to be low. And what is diversification, which is the next point? Diversification means doing something different apart from what the organization was doing. That means launching new products, new investment, new products. So for those new investments, for launching new products, for doing something new, for new projects, the fixed capital requirement is going to be high. So if there is a diversification, yes, then the fixed capital requirement is going to be high. And if there is no diversification, then the requirement will be low. Then we have availability of finance and lease facilities. If somebody is helping the company with some financing facilities, if somebody is lending loan, is helping in any way by giving some advance payment, then in that case, if the availability is there of financing, of help, the company will be in need of high fixed capital, right? And if the availability of financing is no financing available, then they need it low. Level of collaboration, joint venture. Now, collaboration, I have taught you this before also, and joint venture, when two companies come together and starts working. So over here, when the two companies are coming together, obviously the companies, out of two companies, definitely one company might be very good in its infrastructure, good in its assets, good in its tools and equipments and technology. So in that case, if the level of collaboration is really high, is really good, then the need of fixed capital requirement is low. But if there is no joint venture, the two companies are, both of them are financially not that sound, technologically not too sound, infrastructure wise not too sound, then they will be needing more fixed capital. The requirement is going to be more. So that was all about the fixed capital. See you all in the last video, in the next video of the chapter. Thank you.